If photography is writing with light, then teaching ourselves to find, recognize, create, or utilize light and shadow is really the greatest skill we can teach ourselves. If we get this one right, we will be able to take evocative images no matter what camera we have in hand. One of the questions I get asked most often is, how do you recognize good light? It's a great question, maybe the question, but a very hard one to answer. So I'm making this series to let you in on my thinking around how I compose and expose an image, hoping it will inspire you to see the quality of light and shadow in your own daily wanderings and get you thinking about how to write with it. You might be walking around with your friends and want to take a quick portrait, but you need to find natural light that works for it. You don't have strobes or a studio, so you need to find light that's available that's going to make them look good. So Sarah and I have just been walking around London and we found this cool little alleyway which will demonstrate this quite well. It's nice and long, so if I shallow the depth of field, there's going to be a nice sense of depth in the background. This kind of yellow sign in the back is a bit of a pain, but all I'm going to do is put Sarah right in front of that so it takes it out of the equation. And then in terms of light, if you look behind me, there is a nice big open area above and nice and high where the light's coming from. It's not direct sunlight, it's indirect light, and that's what's going to light her, that kind of one big light source above. Nothing from the wall at the end. And then what will happen is the walls on either side here, which are kind of darker walls, are going to almost act as black flags like you'd have in a studio. If you have a big black flat surface, you can bring it close to the face and it deepens the shadow. So if you look at my face at the moment, you've got nice highlights on the top and the nose and the cheeks from that light above. It's almost like I'm bringing a nice big beauty dish overhead that kind of lights that area. And then the walls on either side are making sure that my cheeks are dark and they're creating nice shape in the face. So let's use this and see how we go. So the shots we're getting aren't bad, but unfortunately, because the light's so high, it's creating kind of panda eyes. You can see on my face at the moment, the eye sockets are just too dark because the light is really high. So we're going to use something that you use in studio a lot, and it's called butterfly lighting, which is where you put a nice beauty dish overhead, and then you bring a reflector underneath to kind of fill in those shadows where you want. And unfortunately, we didn't bring a reflector, but Sarah in her bag had a little Topshop bag, which is going to be perfect. And I'm going to get her to hold it just out of shot under her chin. And if you look at my face now, this is with no bag. And I'm going to bring the bag slowly underneath my chin here. And you can see how that fills in those shadows. And I can control how much of those shadows I want to lift and how much I kind of want to deepen them. And just having a piece of white paper or anything white like this will give you the option to sort of play with those shadows and put them where you want. And the other nice thing as well is the closer and further away I bring them, I've got that top catch light in my eye from the light above already, but bringing this underneath puts a second catch light in the bottom of my eye, which looks really good, and also helps me to sort of put a bit of color back in the iris as well, which makes them pop. So let's see if this makes a difference. So for camera, I'm using my Fuji X-T20 with the 35mm f1.4 in it. F1.4 is nice in this case because it's going to give me that shallowing of the depth of field and a really nice slice of focus that gives depth to the shot and shows kind of the depth of the alley. But it also gives me a bit more width than a traditional portrait lens, like a 50 on this would be about an 85. But that would kind of kill some of the context, and I want the context in the shot as well. Settings on the camera are f1.4. I want that shallow depth of field. I'm on 1/500th of a second, so no chance of motion blur because I'm shaking or anything like that. That's going to be rock solid. And I'm on ISO 200. For those who care, I'm shooting with the classic chrome preset. I just like it as kind of a base color mix to edit from.